Radio Raheem here with Frank Buglioni. It's been a tough night, man. That was a surprise to everyone, I'm sure, you the most of all. So just talk to me about the start of the fight and what went wrong.
Listen, we knew he was dangerous. We knew he was a big puncher. I had confidence in my power, and I caught him and I hurt him, and probably just got too careless, and he came back with a cracking left hook and capitalised. And credit to him, he's been through a tough time of it, and coming through that win, remaining undefeated through the long layoff he's had and all the personal problems. And now credit to him and massive respect, and good luck to him moving forward. I'd love to get the rematch with him, but I appreciate if he wants to move on and try and secure some big paydays. That's his prerogative.
What was the shot that you feel like you hit him with and hurt him?
I thought I caught him with a right hand. I know he's got a gash over his head. Just went in to congratulate him, and he's got a big mark, and I think it's a cut. So that was the right hand that I felt that I landed, and I kind of felt it through the body, and I see the legs buckle slightly. Just got careless, and then he come back with a cracking left hook, and obviously I didn't hold it as well as what he did, and he finished me up, so I've got to take my hat off to him.
There were some lulls in the action even after he caught you. Did you recover and get caught again, or was it that you never came back?
I felt I recovered, and then he caught me again, and I tried to recover. I thought I was kind of there, but my legs were still a little bit unsteady, and the referee knows what he's looking for, and he made the call to finish it, so no qualms there. But obviously I'm always going to say I wish I could have fought one, and I'd rather have been flat on my back, but that's what the referee's there for, to save you to fight another day, and that'll come.
Yeah, well, in the moment you definitely took exception to the referee waving the thing off there.
Of course. Listen, I'm disappointed. I'm in there. If I'm going to be beat and I'm going to be knocked out, then I want to be knocked clean out. If I'm on my feet, then I still feel like I've got a puncher's chance. But it's down to the referee, and you've got to respect it.
And lastly, any fighter will tell you, in victory or defeat, you learn something in there every night that you step through the ropes. What was the lesson tonight?
Don't take that left hook on the chin. No, obviously, don't. When you land a decent shot, don't try and go looking for it too much. Stick to your boxing. We knew he was going to be dangerous for three rounds, and he was. He was very dangerous in the first round. It's one of those things. It's a hard lesson learnt, but it's a lesson I'll learn and come back from.
I have spoken to him. He doesn't seem keen on the rematch. So if that doesn't happen, what would be a next step for you, or how do you climb back into the spot in this sport where you want to be?
I've got to secure myself in a mandatory position again, whether it be fight Jose Burton or Anthony Yard, and then chase after that fight. I think it'll probably vacate the Commonwealth. He may vacate the British. So again, it's his prerogative. He's the champion. He has to do what he wants to do, and I respect that. So I'll look to get that British title for keeps.
Well, the fight doesn't always go your way. Some fighters have to lose on some nights, and this might be yours, but you fought hard. We love to see you in the ring. Can't wait to see you step through those ropes again. Radio Raheem with Frank Buglioni.